और अदर गैलेक्सीज, या अदर गैलेक्सीज एंड सो मेनी अदर थिंग्स दैट वी आर लुकिंग फॉर. सो यू माइट बी नोइंग अबाउट हबल स्पेस टेलीस्कोप. आई थिंक फ्यू पीपल मे हैव हर्ड अबाउट इट, मोस्ट ऑफ यू मे हैव हर्ड अबाउट इट. सो हबल टेलीस्कोप्स ओवर द लास्ट आई थिंक 1990 when it was launched, and last 30 years it has provided us lot of beautiful images of the universe, including far away stars and galaxies. So I would really recommend all the people to, after this session, go and check about Hubble Space Telescope, when it was launched, what are the technical aspects it were there, and what are or and most miss the best thing about Hubble Space Telescope is how it has changed our view about the universe. So how is Hubble Space Telescope has shown us the far away objects that earlier we could not see. Okay, so this is one aspect that why we want to make rockets and launch many things in the space. Then we are sending our people also in the space to learn more about space environment and all. So this is actually very initial steps all around the world that people are traveling in the space. And in 1969 already humans have traveled to moon, and now so many countries like US, in US SpaceX, they are trying to go to moon again. Then they are planning for Mars, Mars also. So these are the things that we can achieve through space science. Okay, so so basically, I can say that the space science includes one, engineering. Engineering aspects mainly gives us how we can make rockets, and how we can fly them, and how we can make sure they are safe enough for our payload, in the sense like satellites and space telescopes, like those things, and for people also, for how they are safe. Then we are sending these rockets to the space, and how over the, if you see the space, the environment is very hazardous. Hazardous means like the temperature will be very less, like it will be minus 250 degrees Celsius or minus 270 degrees Celsius even. So in that environment, how whatever system we have made, how it is going to work there. So all engineering aspects, whatever we have learned over the years, that we have to apply in the rockets as well as satellites, and the functioning of all these things. So engineering is very important for the rocketry, for space science. Then next is coming to science aspect. Science aspect is actually very interesting aspect, because in science, what we are going to do, we are going to learn new things, what we did not, we do not know till now about space, of course, then about planets, moons, and other galaxies also. So this is very interesting thing that we can learn about, learn through all this space science. So now coming to the space science, what is the career in space science? So it is not simply just actually it mainly depends upon what you like. It is not something that we people can tell you, okay, you go and do this. They, of course, people can guide you, but you can see what interests you. So I'll just give you some examples. You want, suppose you want to work in space industry. So one thing you can do, either you can become an engineer, rocket engineer, you can make rockets. And rocket engineer also includes so many different engineers, like mechanical engineer who take care of all the structural aspects. I'll go into that little late. Okay, then there are propulsion engineers who take care, okay, what kind of fuel, like we are putting diesel or petrol in our car, so what kind of fuel we are going to put into rocket so that rocket can reach to the heights that we want. Or suppose we want to go to Mars, okay, diesel is okay for that, or we should put petrol, or we should look for something else, like we are doing in. So these kind of things, there are propulsion engineer. Then rocket has to reach from point A to point B. Point A to, suppose you are going from Earth to we are moon. So which direction you have to take? Suppose you want to go to from Delhi to Lucknow, or Delhi to Trivandrum. you can take either train, you can take flight also. So there are some trains will reach early, some trains will reach late, and flight will reach fastest way. So like this also, if you want to go from Earth to Moon, so what kind of rocket you have to have, that you have to decide. Then what kind of fuel you have to have, that you have to decide. So for that, for all those things, propulsion engineer is required. Then which direction you are going to take? Suppose you want to travel in a straight line from Earth to Moon, or you can take any curved path from Earth to Moon, or if you are going to Mars, then you can directly go to Earth, from Earth to Mars, or should I first go to Moon, then should I go to Mars? So all these things you have to decide. For that, we are having some mission design engineers. What they will do, they will just design the mission, which path or which trajectory we call, which trajectory we should take to reach there with minimum fuel. These mission engineers, they will design this. Then we are having navigation engineers who will decide whenever this rocket is going from one place to another, whether it is on the right path or not. Suppose it is not on the right path, what we have to do? So for that, we have control engineers. So if in engineering itself, we are having so many different aspects, so you can choose any of this. So I guess many of people will be from class 10th or 12th. Any persons are there? Any students from class 10th or 12th? Okay, I get two hands here.
Students, you can raise your hands.
Yeah. Okay. So if you are in class 10th and 12th, so after this, you are going to choose which stream you are going to take. And if you are really interested in space science, you can decide if you want to make a rocket, if you want to make rocket, which kind of, which part of rocket you are interested to make, whether you are going to make structural part, propulsion part, are you interested in propulsion part, or are you interested in electronics part? Okay, so that you can decide on your own. Then this is the engineering aspect that I have talked about. Then we can come to the science aspect of this. Science aspect, we can see there are so many experiments that right now NASA is doing in International Space Station. International Space Station, you might have heard. So many scientists, they are going there, they will stay in the International Space Station for maybe 1 month or 2 months. They will do some experiment. And why to do experiments in International Space Station? Because International Space Station, if we are going, there is no gravity. Okay, and how things behave in gravity, that we want to know. So we'll take some experiment there. Suppose we will take some plant from here to International Space Station. We'll see if there is no gravity, how plant's growth will be there, how it gravity affects plant's growth and all. Those kind of aspects we can see. And why we are doing all these things? Why? Because this is actually a very small step of humankind right now that can lead us to explore other planets, maybe other stars or other galaxies in upcoming future, like 100 years, 500 years or 1,000 years from now. So whatever we are doing right now, it is very small steps, which is very much necessary to excel in the future. So this is the overall idea of rocketry or space science. And in space science, you can there is one very interesting stream of space science, astronomy. So astronomy deals with mainly stars, planets, satellite of planets, galaxies, and all the physical objects that you can see in the universe. How universe has evolved over the time, for last 14 billion years, and how it is going to evolve for next few billion years, whether any other galaxy is going to collide with us, or whether our sun is going to explode or not. All those kind of things astronomy can answer to us. So all these different aspects of space science is available. So depending upon your interest, people can decide upon which aspect you are going to take. So till now, any questions anybody is having? Yes, Radhika.
So I don't have any question, but I just wanted to say that I am like interested in space science, and mainly I want to do like I want to be an astronomer. So I just so I just wanted to ask that what are the steps to reach there? Like how, like in which way I can, you know, just do astronomy.
Okay, so you want to become astronomer. Okay, so can you just give me an idea? Do you understand what is an astronomer? What an astronomer is going to do in future, or what is your plan? Radhika, your voice is not coming.
Yeah, Radhika, I think there is some network issue. Either you can switch off your video and so that we can hear you properly. Till the time we get back to Radhika, anybody
Okay.
else who would like to
Anybody else?
interact?
Any question about space science or astronomy or any engineering aspects?
So
I
yeah,
think no other question.
Tanmay has
Tanmay.
raised a
Yeah,
hand.
Tanmay.
Tanmay, you can
Yes,
unmute
Tanmay.
yourself.
Sir, if we like go to space, so
Yeah.
if we do plantation over there, so can we live without our suits also in space?
This is a very good question, Tanmay. I'll just try to answer this. If we, Tanmay, if we are going to space, so going to space, what does it mean by going to space? First, we have to understand. Okay, going to space means there are planets in our solar system. Okay, you know, there are 8 planets in our solar system, and we can go from one planet to another planet. Okay, so if we are going to other planets and we want to live there, first thing in space, without any space station, we cannot live. Okay, because there is nothing there, no. Okay, no planet. See, if you have to go to a planet or satellite of a planet to live, that is one thing. Okay, now if you are going to a satellite of a planet or a planet where you want to live, first we have to see what are the planets in our solar system or beyond which are habitable. Habitable means they can support life or not. Okay, and if they don't support life, can we change those planets so that they can support life, like plants and all? So I'll just give an example. Suppose you see our Venus. So Venus is a planet which is having very high temperature. It is like going beyond 150 degrees Celsius or 200 degrees Celsius. And it is this temperature is so high that it is very difficult for anything to survive there. So we cannot go there and live. Earth, the temperature is around it is changing from like average temperature. If you see, it is around 20 to 30 degrees Celsius. So some places it will go minus 100 degrees Celsius and all, and 50 degrees Celsius in plus also it can go. But overall, our temperature is where we can live. Okay, then we can go to we can see Mars. If we are seeing the Mars actually daytime and nighttime temperature variation is very high. Okay. Very high in the night, it can go minus 50 degrees, 60 degrees Celsius also. And in the daytime, it can go above 100 degrees Celsius also. So this temperature gradient is there. But surely, some of the scientists, when they have sent some rovers and all, they have looked for very essential components that is required for us to live. That is water. And some scientists argue that water is available on the Mars. Okay. So many of people like Elon Musk of SpaceX, then NASA, many people, then China and India also, they are trying to explore Mars as much as possible. And if we are going there, first thing, if you go there and plant trees, directly it will not work. Because for trees to survive, we need particular temperature. We need particular, means we need air also. We need particular temperature, then some nutrients also from the soil. Those things are required. Okay, now Mars into a habitable planet. So some people have given some theories that Mars, first thing what we have to transform in Mars. Okay, Mars atmosphere is very thin. Suppose you are having air at Earth. Okay, so we can breathe normally, but if we are going to Mars, okay, air is very, very less. Okay, like if you are having 100 air here, so there you will have only 1% of that. Okay, so it is like 1/10. So it is very difficult for you to breathe, for you as well as plants. So first, what they will do, they will go to Mars, and people will build some enclosed spaces. Suppose they will build one house there. Okay, that is altogether that is not connected to outer atmosphere, and inside that house they can control air, they can control moisture, they can control water, everything, and they can start planting some tree in some dome shaped houses and all. Okay, and over the time, when number of trees grows, and it will take actually thousands of thousands of years if we take like this. Okay, and over the time, if this trees grows, number of domes grows, then we can think about increasing the density, if you know what density means. Density of the air means we need more gases in atmosphere, Mars atmosphere. Okay, it can be done, but it is take a lot of time, like hundreds of 500 or 1,000 years to do. But and it is possible to do on Mars, but if you see all other planets, they are either very cold or very hot, so it will be impossible to do all these things there. But Mars, definitely we can try, and people are definitely trying all these things. Like Elon Musk of SpaceX, he has recently told that we can increase the amount of carbon dioxide in their atmosphere. And as you know, that carbon dioxide is very essential for growth of trees. Okay, so those things, so we can do, we can establish some factories there. Okay, and we can pump carbon dioxide into the atmosphere, and it will increase later over the hundreds of years. If atmospheric gases comes to our required level, then we can plant trees there, and we can think of going there and live there. I think that would answer your question, Tanmay.
So I would really like to mention, sir, Tanmay is a very, very young robotist, Satwas Robo, and you know, his thought process is so creative, and he is so always so anxious to, you know, ask very good questions. So well done, Tanmay. Hope you understood what sir has mentioned.
Yes,
Tanmay.
Sir, can we live on Jupiter?
Yes, Tanmay. Go ahead.
Sir, can we live on Jupiter?
No, Tanmay, we cannot live on Jupiter, because if you read about Jupiter, Jupiter is a mainly gaseous planet. What do I mean by gaseous planets? It is, if you go to the Jupiter and see all, if you try to descend into Jupiter, you will find out that the first atmosphere is very light, but as you go inside, the gas like hydrogen, helium, those kind of gases, those are so dense that we cannot even reach the surface of the Jupiter. Surface means the actual surface, like Earth, we cannot reach there. Okay, and hydrogen, helium, those kind of gases are in liquid form, which are at very low temperature, at around maybe 4 Kelvin or so. Minus 250 degrees Celsius, minus 270 degrees Celsius. So we cannot live there. And second, this is one aspect why we cannot live there. Second aspect is Jupiter is so big that its gravity is very, very high. And if we go there now, Earth gravity is very less, like 9.8 meter per second square, if you know about gravity. Then if you go to Jupiter, gravity is so high, if we want to stand there, we cannot stand there, and it will break our bones also. So we cannot live on Jupiter. We can live on the planets which are similarly sized to Earth. Suppose Earth is having a radius of 6,400 kilometers. So somewhere between half of the Earth to the double or one and a half of the Earth, those kind of planets we can explore to live. So that Earth, there is some gravity, okay? And if you are going to Mars, Mars is almost half of Earth's size. So gravity will be much less than Earth. So to keep your body in shape, you have to do a lot of exercise on Mars if you want to live on Mars. Otherwise, your bone will be very lightweight, and they can crack easily. It will be a very difficult situation otherwise. Yeah. Okay. तन्मय, नाइस क्वेश्चन.
So Radhika, now you can go
राधिका,
ahead.
यू कैन गो अहेड.
Yeah, so actually I'm so sorry, there was a network issue in
No,
between,
that
so I
not a problem.
So I was like saying that what are the steps to reach the to become an astronomer, because I know the main thing that we have to mainly is physics, maths and all, so I'm opting, I'm like going for that, but I want to know in how such way that I can become an astronomer, it would be like easy for me to
I asked a question before that. Na, to actually, do you know what kind of work or what do astronomers do actually?
Yeah, they are actually, first of all, like they are master in the field of astronomy, and they research things about suns, stars, planets, which are beyond like the scope of Earth. So they only make such discoveries that we know, like how do we know that Jupiter is the like you know how do we know that Earth is the third planet which revolves sun? It's like all because of them they make discoveries, and like I'm interested in that. So yeah.
Oh, nice. So you really know about astronomy. So being an astronomer, actually, what you have to do, first thing, actually, there are many steps that you can take. First thing that you have to have your background. Two things you will be needing a very good background. First is physics, second is mathematics. Okay, so when you are entering into the astronomy at the beginning, so it is like more sort of all beautiful pictures that we are looking at, like a beautiful picture of Jupiter or Sun or other galaxies or some asteroids and all. Okay, so very interesting things come at the beginning. Okay, so what we do, what astronomers really do, they will just look at all these things, then they will try to study different planets, and they'll tell, okay, this planet is having such and such atmosphere. Okay, we have not gone there, but we know from here, means that what is the atmosphere of Jupiter or what is the atmosphere of Venus? We have not gone there. Miss Venus, anyway, one probe has gone, but before going there, we were knowing what is the atmosphere made of. Okay. So for that, there is a branch of astronomy, a spectroscopy, not astronomy, it is a chemistry. So as the spectroscopy, so we can from far away, we can see by seeing the what kind of light is coming from that particular planet or star, we can say what kind of materials are available there. So if you, which class you are in actually?
I'm an 8, sir.
Yes, standard. Okay, when you are coming to 10th or 12th class, you will be reading about more about spectroscopy and all. So spectroscopy, what it does it do? It tells, suppose any light is passing through any particular kind of material. Okay, so when it passes through, the little characteristic of light changes, and if we analyze the light later, we'll know what kind of material it has gone through. Okay, so this is the basic principle of spectroscopy, and then we can understand what kind of this planet is made of. Okay, so this is just for an example I give. So you need to understand first, you need to have a very good background of physics. Okay, physics means how things work, Newton's first, second, third laws. Okay, then characteristics of light. I'm doing some examples on it. So characteristics of light, how gravity works, what is the theory of gravity and all those kind of things. Overall, you need to have very good grasp over physics. Okay, and when you are starting at physics, one thing comes with physics always, that is mathematics. Okay, so at the beginning of this astronomy, mathematics may not be that much pronounced, but when we are going too much into the astronomy, mathematics is very much required. Okay, without mathematics, it will be next to impossible to do astronomy. Okay, now if you are going want to become astronomer, just up to 12th, you can try to master in basic physics and mathematics. And after that, either you can opt for some physics course or mathematics course for your Miss bachelor's or third. You can also. And apart from that, there are some of the institutions actually in India, very few institutions like IUCA place is there. Then they offer integrated MSc or bachelor's course in astronomy itself. Okay, Exact places I don't remember right now, but you can apply for those courses and you can do your undergraduate in that. And if you are doing that now, it will be very easy for you to enter astronomy field. And right now, in India, actually, astronomy field is not that much mature, but it is increasing very fast right now. It is not that much mature. So you can learn about these things, and by the time you are ready to enter the field of astronomy, I hope India will be very good at this particular aspect. And you can apply for, like, ISRO also, we are having physics research laboratory. So you can apply for that. They are doing some astronomy. Then we are having IUCA, which is Inter-University Center for Astronomy. Okay, that is in Mumbai. You can apply for that. You can study there. You can do research there. Then we are having observatories at different places. Like Mount Abu, we are having an observatory. You can go after completion of all your these studies. You can go there, and then in real time, you can see how we observe whole universe through our telescopes. So those places are there. So you can opt for that. So basically, I'll just tell you: master in physics and mathematics, you do your bachelor's or master's degree either in physics, mathematics, or astronomy. Then you can apply for all these places. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. So is there any other question someone wants to ask? Divit Jain. Yes, Divit.
Can you please tell me what is the significance of making an observatory?
Divit, can you speak a little louder? I cannot hear you.
Okay, sir. Please tell me the significance of making an observatory.
Significance of?
Observatory.
I cannot hear you, Divit.
Divit, I request you to type your question in the chat box. We cannot hear you properly. Mm-hmm. Niharika, you can take the questions from the chat box, right? So anybody who is having some questions, we request you to kindly type it in the chat box so that, you know, we'll be able to address your queries.
Okay.
Divit, are you there? Achha. Significance of an observatory, sir.
Significance of an observatory. Okay. So the basic thing that why we need observatory, first thing. Okay. So observatory we need to study, to see actually. First, we are through observatory, we are seeing only. Suppose you want to, you know, Mars is very, very far away from Earth. And if you want to travel from Earth to Mars, okay. It will take around maybe sometimes 8 months, sometimes 9 months, or sometimes 6 months also, like 6 to 9 months, that kind of time it will take. Okay. So if you want to study few things that you can study from Earth without going there. Okay. So observatories are very useful in those aspects. Suppose you can save a lot of money and you should not go there. You should not go there and just be here and you can study. Like what is the size of this planet? Okay, what is the what kind of material this planet possesses? What kind of atmosphere does it have? Does it have water or not? Sometimes we can know, but sometimes we cannot know. But it is a very good tool that provides, that enables us to give basic idea of things. Suppose food planet, all those things that I have told that we can know. Okay, and we can get other stars. The nearest stars from Earth that we are having, that is Proxima Centauri, and it is 4.2 light years away. So 4.2 light years is such a large distance, so that even if we are going at the speed of light that we cannot go, then it will take 4.2 years for you to reach there actually. So it is so far away. So at this time, what we can do, we can have a very powerful telescope. We can just see that star. And we can see, okay, this particular star, we can calculate through observatory, okay, this particular star is this far away, this particular star is made of this thing, this particular star is having this much mass. Those all kind of things we can get from the light that we are seeing through our telescope. Okay, so this is, in this way, observatories are very, very necessary. And observatories can have different sizes. Suppose at your home, you can have telescopes, which is having a mirror of 2 inch, 4 inch, or even 12 inch. Okay, then suppose you are having a 6 inch or 8 inch telescope. Through that, you can see Jupiter and 4 of Jupiter's moon. Okay, you can see how beautiful the Jupiter looks through the telescope. You can see the rings of Saturn. Okay, and if you want to go further beyond, you need bigger telescope. You have to make bigger observatory. And at Earth, bigger observatories are available in India. We are having at Mount Abu. Okay, then if you are going outside of India, then you must have heard about the place Hawaii. Okay, so they are having a lot of observatory there. It is part of US, and they are having biggest of the observatories on Earth that is there. And observatories not only see in visible light, what you see by your eyes, not only in that light. Observatories can see beyond that. They can see either in infrared, or they can see ultraviolet or radio, X-ray, all kind of waves they can see. And through those waves, we can analyze what kind of star this is, or galaxies, or as a whole universe, how does it look? So one interesting observatory that you can say, that is Hubble telescope, that is a space observatory, you can say. And it has provided us so beautiful picture that earlier I told. And we have mapped our observable universe, and so much beautiful pictures are available for that. And now we know that approximately how many stars they are there in our own Milky Way, or how many stars are available in other, how many galaxies are available in observable universe. When I say observable universe, this means the universe that we can observe through telescopes or observatories. Okay, universe is much bigger than that, but we can see only a part of that. So for knowing all these things, observatories are definitely required. Yes, Divit. Okay, Divit, I guess I answered your question.
So hope, Divit, you have understood. So yes. Tanmay has another query wherein, you know, he's asking, what if an asteroid hit the sun?
What will happen? Tanmay, very good question, actually. Okay, so what will happen if asteroid hit the sun? Okay, so first thing we have to decide, what is the size of this asteroid? Okay.
If the size of the asteroid is as big as sun.
As big as sun. Okay. Okay, Tanmay. So one thing I will just clarify. If it is as big as sun, okay. One thing, if it is such big, then you cannot really specify it as asteroid. Asteroids are actually much smaller. There is no real definition of asteroid is available, but one vague definition, small definition I can give. If you see orbit of the Mars and orbit of the Jupiter, okay, between this orbit, there are so many planet-like objects. They are they will not be circular. They are like very small pieces. When I say telling small, it may be few kilometers or hundreds of kilometers. Okay, so asteroid cannot be as big as planet. Suppose it is as big as planet, it should be, it will be defined as a planet. Okay, so Tanmay, you want to say something? Hello?
Yes, sir. Okay.
You wanted to say something?
Sir, no, I didn't want, but I wanted to say, does Jupiter has 67 plus moons?
Yes.
Okay,
Tanmay, I'll come to that question before, first I'll answer that asteroid question. Okay, so first thing, I have defined what asteroid is. So asteroid cannot be as big as star or as big as planet. They're small. So small means they may be hundreds of kilometers. Okay, that much only. How it will affect the sun, or how it will affect us. Okay, suppose when you are going to a pond, or you are going to a river, you take one stone and just drop in water. What will happen? Water will splash. Okay, suppose you are taking bigger stone and then throwing in the water again. What will happen? splash will be bigger. And if you are keep on increasing this thing, what will happen over the time? Like your stone will be so big that your water will come out. Sometimes water may come out of the pond also. Okay. So this same analogy you can take to our sun, the asteroid system also. Okay. Now suppose you are hitting a very small asteroid, 1 kilometer, 2 kilometer, 10 kilometer. The radius of sun is so large. I think 150,000 kilometer. I am not sure right now. 150,000 kilometer. So it is so large that this our asteroid is having negligible effect on that. Okay. Suppose you are hitting very large asteroid. One hypothetical asteroid that is as big as Earth. Okay. If you are hitting that, so what will happen? Nothing much will happen at the point where it is hitting. So some of the sun's material, okay, and sun is mainly made of hydrogen and helium. Some of that material is splashed for some time, and after some time it will go back to normal. Okay, so asteroids cannot do much to the sun. And even before hitting the sun, what will happen? Sun's gravity is so large, it will dismantle the satellite before that by first thing gravity, second heat. Okay. So next question, one more thing you have asked about Jupiter. I forgot that. Tanmay?
How does Jupiter have 67 plus moons?
Right.
Natural satellites.
Yes. So natural satellite, what does it mean by natural satellite? That suppose Earth is there. Okay, Earth is a planet. And moon is going around this. Okay. So moon is a natural object and it is going around Earth, so it is a natural satellite. Like moon, suppose any other object was there which is natural and it was going around Earth, we would consider it as a satellite. Okay, now coming back to Jupiter. Okay, actually Jupiter is having so many satellites, you can say thousands or even lakhs of satellites. Why I'm saying so? Because Jupiter is having some bigger satellites which you can see through telescopes and all. Okay, and there are some smaller things, like maybe 1 kilometer satellite will be there, or maybe 100 meter or 1 meter, or maybe smaller than that. Okay, those particles are there which are orbiting around Jupiter. If you see Jupiter closely, you will find a ring around the Jupiter like Saturn. Okay, all these smaller objects can be considered a satellite, but we will not do that. We will not consider them satellite because those satellites are not stable. They are not in a stable orbit. What will happen? They will frequently, suppose they are going in a ring and there are thousands of other objects going in the same ring. Sometimes they may collide each other. Okay. They will collide, and after collision, they can break apart, or two parts can mix together. It can become a bigger. Okay. So we'll not consider those satellites. The only natural objects which are having a definitive path around your planet, those will consider a satellite. And till now we have observed whatever you are telling, 67 plus satellites, and we have named them. Scientists have named them 67 plus satellites, and scientists are still exploring if any more satellites are available. And definitely after a few years we'll get to know some more satellites. Yeah, so answer is yes, it is having more than 67 satellites. So many other questions have come, I am seeing.
So I have another two doubts.
Yeah.
So like the first doubt is that we know that the biggest asteroid found in our solar system is Ceres. So what if it hit Earth? Will Earth get destroyed?
Yeah, actually, Ceres is the biggest asteroid. You know what is the diameter of Ceres? Miss, how big is it approximately?
It's known as a dwarf planet, but I don't remember.
We will not go into dwarf planet. It is okay. Even I don't know right now what is the size, but it is the biggest asteroid. Okay, suppose it is 100 kilometers asteroid. Okay, so what will happen on Earth? As you remember, from at around 65 million years ago, on Earth, all the dinosaurs were there. Okay, so if you see the history, from 220 million years to 65 million years ago, all this span, dinosaurs were thriving on Earth. Okay, so what happened exactly at 65 million years ago that all the dinosaurs and most of the Earth's population means all the species, more than 95% of the species have died. That time is when asteroid hit Earth. Okay, so this asteroid hit Earth. So what has happened and what will happen if Sirius hit Earth? So answer will be same only for this. So instantaneously it will not erase all the life on Earth, but eventually it will. How it will happen? First, it is going to hit Earth at some location. Suppose it is hitting some Earth mass. Either it can hit Earth some land mass, or it can hit water body like ocean. Okay. So suppose it is hitting land mass. What will happen? First, the asteroid will enter into our atmosphere, and atmosphere will start to burn this asteroid. So the temperature of the atmosphere will increase at that location at that time. Okay. And it will keep on increasing because a lot of heat energy will be coming out of asteroid because of burning of the asteroid. Once it hit Earth at some landmass, what will happen instantaneously at that location, everything will vaporize because temperature will be so high that everything at that location will eventually vaporize. Maybe few tens of kilometers or 100. Suppose it is 10 kilometer asteroid, then around 100 kilometer, everything will start burning suddenly. Okay. And because of this impact, what will happen? One shock wave will start forming, and this shock wave will travel thousands of kilometers, and it will destroy everything that is coming in its place, and it will start burning all things around it. Okay. And that is first aspect. Then what will happen after this? What will happen at the point of impact where it has hit? From there, so much debris will come out so that it will start flying into the atmosphere. Okay, it will go to thousands of kilometers, it will fall there, and one smoke cloud will form over the impact point. Okay, and over the months, this smoke, all smoke will try to disperse into our atmosphere, but this smoke is so high that over the time it will cover whole the Earth and we cannot get any sun's rays. Okay. And if there is no sun rays over the time, over a few years, what will happen? Our Earth's temperature will drop and will freeze to death. Whatever has not burned, that will freeze to Earth, freeze to death. Okay. So this is what will happen. And suppose it is hitting ocean. Okay. Then what will happen? Very big tsunami waves will form. At the point of impact, anyway, everything will heat up and all water waves will be vaporized instantaneously. And the temperature of the atmosphere will increase, and whatever has not burned, that water will be displaced and tsunami waves will be formed, and they will consume all the landmass. And again, same thing will happen. Everyone will die if Sirius hits Earth. Okay.
So,
but
what about Mount Everest? Will it also sink?
I'm not sure actually Mount Everest will sink or not. But we can do some calculations depending upon the asteroid size, whether it will sink or not. But definitely what will happen, anyway, it is frozen most of the places, but everywhere it will be frozen later. Okay. But I'm not sure actually. I will just do some calculation and whether it is possible to sink Mount Everest. Sometimes it may be possible. Yeah.
Where are the satellites made?
Yes, Ashmit?
Where are the satellites made?
Okay, good question. Satellites actually made, actually in ISRO, we are having one space application center, one center in Ahmedabad. Mainly, most of our satellites they are making, whatever requirement is there. Okay, suppose government will propose some requirement on the satellite. They want to see over the time how Earth is changing. Okay, so they will give the requirement to Space Application Center Ahmedabad. They will study the requirement. Depending upon that requirement, they will make the satellite and give to us, and we'll launch the satellites. Okay, this is what government is doing. suppose there are some private companies also. They can also make their own satellite. Okay, they can have their own facilities to make satellites, and they can give to us or other space agencies to launch. So nowadays, many private agencies are also coming to make satellites. You might have heard recently, few people have made some nano satellites, like looking very small satellites, and they were launched later. They were launched in some launch vehicles also. So you can also make your own satellite depending upon very small requirements also. So in ISRO is making at SAC Ahmedabad Space Communication Center, and if you want, you can make your own satellite also.
So are these satellites and rockets are made like satellites have.
Yes, Ashmit.
Then where are the rockets made?
Where are the rockets made? Okay, rockets rocket is actually a very, like satellite, rocket is also very big hardware. Okay, so
they are also made in like Ahmedabad.
No, they are not made in Ahmedabad. That I'm coming to that answer. Actually, our rocket, if you see, rocket is having so many parts. Okay, so these parts we are assembling together, and these parts are made at different places. Okay, some of the parts are made, suppose you are having tanks where you are going to store your fuel or oxidizer. Okay, whatever propellant you are storing, that will be made in Bangalore. Okay, then there are some parts which will be made in Trivandrum, some parts will be made in Mumbai. So it is like we are having different centers. Okay, and we'll assign each center to make. Okay, you will say one person, okay, you make the engine. We'll say other person, you make the tanks. We'll say other person, you get everything and integrate everything together and fly. So like this, all things are made at different places all over the India. Some places Bangalore, Mumbai, and some places Hyderabad, Trivandrum, even Kanyakumari. Okay. Then everything is taken together to Sriharikota, and it is launched from there. Yes.
So I have one more doubt that, yes. We all know that space is very cold, like it's the temperature is in minus. So how hot is the sunlight in space?
Actually, it is a very difficult question. I'll try to answer that also. When we talk about the temperature of something, what do we mean by the temperature of something? Okay, suppose you are having one thermometer, okay, and you are having fever, okay, you'll check your temperature, you'll put below your armpit or in your mouth, and you'll check what is the temperature, okay. So this is what it is doing here. The thermometer, it is sensing at around this thermometer, whatever material or matter is there, what is the temperature of that? Okay, maybe the temperature of saliva. Okay, maybe the temperature of your skin, like that. Okay, so and if you are going having a thermometer and you are putting in water, so what it will check the temperature of water. Okay, what is the temperature of water? If you are going into the space, there is nothing there. There is no gas, no water, nothing. So what temperature it will measure? Okay, do you know what temperature it will measure if nothing is around?
Sir, I don't know, but like I just know that I just had a doubt that if space is like cold, then
I'm coming to that point now. Since nothing is around to measure, what it will measure, one thing is coming: electromagnetic radiation from sun. Okay, so electromagnetic radiation from sun is coming. Whatever electromagnetic radiation is coming, that will be coming with some energy. Okay, so whenever it is hitting your thermometer, it will sense, okay, this much energy I'm having, and this much energy corresponds to this much temperature. So this is what it will measure. Okay, so now when we say that temperature of the space is very cold, okay, that means how we are measuring that, what we'll do, we'll take very big space, okay, and we'll see total energy content of that, okay. And because of the total energy content, what is the average temperature of that particular space? Okay, so that's how we are arriving at very low temperature. So as such, the temperature of space at particular point, it does not have any meaning. Temperature, average temperature of space is having meaning. Okay, that is what we are calculating. Okay, so we are calculating and we have calculated the average temperature of space is at around 2.7 Kelvin. Okay, that is like minus 270 degrees Celsius. Okay, so that is the temperature of space. And if you go to the space, if somebody is going to the space and they are not having space shoes and all, so what will happen? Whatever energy is there in your body, that will go out. Suddenly everything will become very cold. Okay, and like most of the time, like if we are not having proper space shoot, people within a minute or two, people die actually. Okay, that's why you have to take too much precautions. Okay, so to answer your question, average temperature, we can talk about only average temperature of space, not temperature at a particular point. And whatever temperature of sun and all is there, that we can check by reading about that. Earlier I told you, spectroscopy method. We'll see. I'll just explain one more thing here. How we are checking the temperature of stars and sun. Okay, we'll observe different stars in different different rays, suppose X-rays or visible rays or infrared. Okay, and depending upon all the energy that they are having, that will map on a spectrograph, and we'll see this particular color of this particular color will corresponding to the corresponding temperature. Okay, from there we can derive the temperature of particular star. We can never go there and put a thermometer to check. It's like it is not possible. Okay, so we can only do spectroscopy method to check very high temperature.
And Niharika ma'am, I have two questions.
Yes.
I wanted to ask ma'am that in the package now, there was a string and a sandpaper. They told us we have to use it, but they didn't tell us how to use it.
So Vivan, I think we can take this question offline. So if you have any particular query, we'll
what
definitely...
is question? What is question? Can you
so explain? Basically, sir, he's asking about some of the parts in the model rocketry kit, so which they have made. So he's asking about the sandpaper and the string. So basically, Vivan, that string was to be used to just balance your rocket, and sandpaper, you can use it if it is required, you know, maybe while pasting few of the parts, if you still need to balance the, you know, the object. So that's how, where you can use it. Still, we'll take this question offline, Vivan.
Sir,
I understand.
To be honest, I didn't understand, I didn't like properly understand what you explained, like also the
last question, for now you can understand that. See, your question was that space is very cold, right? Can you explain your question again, then I'll try to answer in simple ways.
How hot is sunlight in space?
How hot is sunlight in space? So how heat is transferred from one place to another place, that you must be aware, that either it can go through some medium or it can directly come from as a rays. Okay, so from sun to space, sun to earth, there is no medium. So only electromagnetic waves are coming. Okay, so if you are having at International Space Station, whatever temperature you will measure, okay, it is due to only whatever sun rays are coming. Okay, so your question is what is the temperature of the sunlight in space?
How hot is sunlight in space?
How hot is sunlight in space? Okay.
Sir, I think so it will be 10 degrees Celsius.
10 degree, why you so think it is 10 degrees Celsius?
Celsius, 10 degrees.
Yeah. Okay, Radhika, actually, this the correct temperature, how much it will be there, that I'm not sure. But one thing is very much sure, when you are at space, okay, and there is when you are talking about temperature at one particular point. It is not non-definite. You cannot define temperature at a particular point. You have to take average only. Okay, that is one thing. Other thing, if you are in space station, okay, then whatever the sunlight is coming on the surface of the our space station, okay, you can put some sensor there and you can measure what is the temperature because of sunlight. Okay, that can be measured. Exact number I don't have right now, but it will be very cold because whatever sunlight is coming from space to our surface of the from the sun to our ISS, so almost most of it will be reflecting back. Okay, and whatever the temperature,
the heat, like the whatever you're saying, like the how hot is sunlight in space. So you're saying like it is cold and coming, like reaching to Earth, it is hot, like because it is traveling in space.
No, actually it okay, I will try to answer in this way. Suppose you are going in space around 500 kilometers above Earth. Okay, so whatever suppose Earth was 500 kilometers bigger than right now, okay, then also you will feel almost same temperature what you are feeling now. Okay, so if you are at 500 kilometers above Earth, okay, so that time you will feel the same temperature as Earth, but since there is no atmosphere at 500 kilometers, you will not feel the similar effects what you are seeing at Earth right now, because at Earth you are feeling the temperature of air around you, but in space there is no air around you. Okay, so you will not feel, you will feel cold only actually, because whatever energy you are receiving from the sun, that will be instantly, most of it will be reflected, some of it will be absorbed in your space suit and all. But since you are having some body temperature of around 37 degrees Celsius, and space, whatever average temperature of the space is -270 degrees Celsius, so your body will also be radiating. Okay, so you will be feeling very, very, very cold actually in space.
So the, like, even like in spite of the sun being there, I'll feel cold in the space, right?
Yes,
like
definitely.
The rays traveling. So whenever the rays are traveling, like in the space, like through the space to reach Earth, so they are all traveling in the energy. So that energy, when like reaches the, like the ozone layer, then the heat gets like reflected on the,
nothing like that. But what happens actually, from sun to Earth, these electromagnetic rays are coming. Okay, so what is happening from sun till atmosphere starts? Okay, there is nothing there. Okay, so whatever your rays are coming, it will, whatever energy is coming from Earth to sun to here, it will be same energy. Okay, so but as same energy in the sense, like okay, we can assume it is same, because suppose sun is having some radius and whatever rays are going out. So after some time, if you draw one circle, it will be a bigger circle. Okay, so in the bigger circle, whatever energy will be little bit less. Okay, but when you are hitting, but it is not being absorbed by anything from sun till our atmosphere. But as soon as these rays are hitting our atmosphere, okay, and it is entering our atmosphere, what will happen? Atmosphere is having oxygen, carbon dioxide, all those things. So some of the energy of these waves are being absorbed by all these particles, mainly by carbon dioxide and water vapors. Okay, so these all water vapors, everything, these contain, they get the energy from the sun's energy, the sun's rays, and they contain in our atmosphere. So that's why our temperature is almost 20 degree to 40 degrees Celsius. That kind of temperature will get all around the Earth. Okay. So till atmosphere, energy is not being distributed in any other material. Okay, but as soon as it comes to the atmosphere, will absorb some of the energy. And whenever it is hitting the Earth, so that energy will be little less. Yeah.
Okay.
So, excuse me, sir. Just another question. That if you told that if an asteroid hits the sun, it will emit some of its material. Can this material damage the atmosphere or Earth?
It may actually. If Earth happens to be in the way of that material ejection, it will definitely, it depends upon how much material is ejected from the sun. Okay, you might have heard about solar flares. Okay, solar flares are the events that are continuously happening on the sun. What will happen in solar flare? Because of the some internal activities going inside the sun, some of the material will be ejected, okay, and it will be going through the space. Okay, suppose Earth is in the way, what will happen? It will definitely what it will consist of high energy particles like alpha particles and all, very high energy particles will be there, and if they directly hit the Earth, then Earth will definitely be destroyed, or at least some part of it will be destroyed. But Earth is having very good defense mechanism. It is having an electromagnetic cloud above us. Electromagnetic cloud means, you know that Earth is having North Pole and South Pole, and Earth is magnetic. Okay. And whatever this magnetic field is, because of this magnets, Earth is having magnetic field around Earth. Okay. And whenever this charged particles are coming from the sun, so this magnetic field, what it will do, it will deflect most of the particles away from Earth, and Earth will be saved. Okay, so depending upon if too much material is coming, so sometimes a magnetic field may not save us, but most of the time small material coming from the sun, this magnetic field saves us actually. Okay.
And like we launch a rocket in space, can we face friction in the space? Like there is the only vacuum, can we face friction?
So, Divit, I would really like to mention here, I think this session could go on, you know, for hours and hours. But yes, just with the interest of time, you know, and as Siddharth sir has committed us, you know, for good 1 hour. So I think we should respect time. And I would request all the students, what we can do is, if you still have any queries, so maybe Siddharth sir can share his email ID and, you know,
we'll
be happy to answer your queries. And thank you so much, Siddharth sir, for sparing your valuable time. And also, I would just like to have one last piece of advice from you for our, you know, young robotists. So what do you advise all of them?
Advice wise, actually, as in the beginning also I told, this robot, okay, all this space science and rocketry, all these things is very interesting. And it all depends upon person to person, what kind of interest do you have? Okay, some people may have interest in mechanical field, some in electrical field, some in astronomy field. And everything in the last comes to the space science. So depending upon that, whatever you are having the interest, do your best in your interest and try to excel in that field. Okay, and once you are excelling in your field, and you can definitely approach, you can come to the space science and all, and you can work for ISRO in the future or any other space organization as you wish. So that is actually, I will leave on the all the person. I think whatever people are here, they are very interactive today, that I want to thank for everyone. Okay, and they look like for their age also, they are very mature. And I can just guide them if anybody is having some doubt. Okay, I can guide them how to proceed in particular field. But whatever field they want to choose, they have to choose on their own, and it should be their interest. Okay. So that is advice from my side.
Thank you so much.
Is it like possible for sir? Is it like possible for like you to tell like is ISRO launching another satellite or any other thing?
Definitely. Actually, ISRO is when we launch a satellite, we'll plan ahead. Like we'll plan ahead 2-3 years ahead. Okay, this day we are going to launch this satellite. That day we are going to launch this satellite. But as you know, that for last 2 years we have been facing coronavirus and COVID situation. So all our plans got delayed a little bit. Okay. So anyway, we are coming back very soon, and most probably in March, there is a March or January, that kind of satellite launches planned. If everything goes as per plan, then we'll launch that. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir, for sharing your time and your knowledge with us. We would like to present a token of thanks. Just one second, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much, Siddharth sir, and thank you, audience. So, sir, we would request you if you could just share your email ID on that so that children can, you know, ask.
Sure. I'll send my email ID to you. Okay. Thanks. So, whatever questions students are having, they can just, I think Niharika can compile and send to me. I'll try to answer most whatever I could.
Sure.
Okay.
Sure.
So we request all the children to kindly send all the questions. We are just typing the email ID in the chat box. So you can send all your queries to info@wizrobo.com and we'll direct your queries to Siddharth sir and definitely we'll get back to you soon. Thank you everyone. Thank you for joining.
Thank you
Siddharth sir. Thanks.
Thank you.
Bye sir. Thank you sir.
Okay, bye.
Thank you.
Bye. Take care. Have a great weekend.
Yeah.